Hello everybody, I'm the One Demand, and welcome to From the Depths. This game, I love it. It's an open world, sort of, strategy building game. And god damn it, I love it. I love games where you can be creative and build whatever you want. And if we look in the background, we see some very creative build designs, like boats and planes and all that, because this game allows you to build pretty much everything. Like, there's pretty much no limit. And all these designs you see right here in the background are player submitted, I think. This game is built around the community, and it's flipping awesome because everything in the factions in-game is made by the community, and that's awesome. Like, seriously, it's super awesome. This game is pure insanity, and I find it fun, entertaining. Well, not really fun, but you can get a lot of time into it. Like, I have little under 100 hours in it, and I think it's amazing. You can use a lot of time in this game. So I'm right now in the vehicle designer, and this is one of my ships, my first actual battleship I made. It's called the Vulcan, and yeah, it's quite terrible. This is the first combat ready ship I made, and it's just horrible. Well, not really, the cannons is bad, but when you pair them with the missiles I have and the guns and all that, it's actually quite good, because there's a lot of different weapon systems, and I only know half of them. The advanced cannons, cram cannons, and the missiles. That's pretty much all I know. And there's flip, and let's go through them real quick. There's a lot of blocks, building blocks, control blocks from both water and airborne vehicles. Advanced control blocks, you can program your ship to do stuff. Like, seriously, you can actually enter in code in the game. I am stupid. And I spelled I am wrong. Like, seriously. Don't save changes. Like, this is just amazing what you can do. You can customize everything. So, there's simple weapons. There's some simple ways too. I haven't ever actually used these. That's a small cannon. Neat. Oh. So, let's see. There's missiles with all these kind of blocks. All these things have their own guides and tutorials in game. And they also say a lot of things, what they do. There's an amazing amount of content in a game that doesn't even take up a single gigabyte on your PC. It takes like 600 or 700 megabytes on your PC. It's quite amazing what they can do with such little space. And oh my god, this game. I just tried recording it with a OBS, and the game is very CPU intensive, so my OBS just like killed itself. Literally. It didn't want to go with the game. We have lasers. We have the advanced cannons, which can turn into what's it called? The rail gun. I don't know. Like, there's also the what's it called? The particle cannons. These are ridiculous. objects, you can make turrets on spin blocks, sub objects. I have turrets to my one of my ships. Prefabs, I'm not going to press that because that will like lag the game out quite much. So yeah, I'll show you what my first little creation here can do. Actually, I'll show my very first boat right here. My very first ship, my first ship, and that was not a typo. It was me being creative. I'm an asshole, and my ship has sunk. Okay, now it floats. Okay, this ship doesn't even have weapons. This is just me trying to figure out how the hell this game works, and it only has an engine. Like, this engine is not even very good. It's just an engine. It works barely. So let's take it for a spin. Let's take it for a spin. Like, you stand near this and you press the weird configuration of buttons up in the left corner. Pressing T for making it go, and it goes. Yay! Super fast. Move around to speed of sound. Can't touch this. Pressing the wrong button. Reversing. Boop boop, motherfucker. Yep. Don't you move, piece of garbage. So, I'll jump. Can I reach? No, I can't. Dragon. Get up. There we go. So, if I. That is Vulcan. That is first ship. Let's put it out of play and destroy it. Now it's just a bunch of resources lying in the water. The controls of this game is quite weird, actually. Like, WASD is movement, space is jump, all that. That is normal, right? But when you go, you can control your weapons by scrolling with the scroll wheel. And by the way, up is down and down is up on the scroll thing, down on the left. And to fire, you either middle click or press control on your keyboard. So, well, I guess left click is for using tools, but if you don't have your... Wait. What am I doing? Oh, right click is punch. I've never used that. Is that for punching AI? Influence? What? I don't know. But, yeah. Left control is shoot weapon. Yeah, this weapon is really good. Can you stop moving?
Turning off.
This menu is the AI control. It controls the AI of the ships. This ship has a small AI. If I go in here, this is the AI of the ship. So when I tell it to
control
I can open the map.
Listening, moving out.
It. So now it should sail by itself. And when you notice that it doesn't follow the lines, it annoys the shit out of you. But I think it has to do with how you
listening.
Do
moving
this.
Out.
And then the ship begins to spasm out like crazy. It's fun to see. But in any case, you're not here to watch me sail a boat. You can just go find Boating Simulator 2021. Or something like that to do that. You are probably here to see
taking control.
This ship fight something. So let's open the spawn menu and open up for the Vanguard retrofit. And we're off. That's a small boat. And bow! The ship's internals is blown into pieces. It's still going. Oh, there went the AI. And it's AI dead. And when it doesn't have an AI, it deconstructs. Or it gets shot by the ship because it's attacking salvage. That's so cool. So let's turn
turning
off.
Turning off.
I have two AIs, one controlling the missiles, the other controlling both movement and the other weapons. So, yeah, this is my first ship. It's really not that good, actually. But it does the job. It does it fairly well. So I'm going to destroy this vehicle. So let's load up another ship. I've worked on some things. So if we go to... let's see. I have this little support ship, which is, I guess, it's okay if I spawn in another ship. Let's see, if I spawn in... well, if I spawn back in the Vulcan. And let's say if we can get it to fire upon itself. I'll just disable my own thing here. So if I use this and fire upon the ship, this support ship is repairing it. So this ship has some things called repair tentacles, and this is repairing other ships around it as long as it has resources with it. This is resource capacity. It's pretty useful. So these two ships is in my fleet on my personal campaign in the game. And I have three of the Vulcans and two of the HMS Zephyrian, as it's called. Because the Zephyrian is the fastest ship I own. Because it's very light, doesn't have any weapons. If we set it to full throttle, you see it goes almost... Oh, it just topped off at 10 meters. Oh.
Turning off.
Myself. Piece of boat. It can just reach above 10 meters a second, which is actually quite fast for this size of boat with no real aerodynamic or hydrodynamic. I don't know what it's called, but it's not very streamlined for boating, I guess. It's more like a floating rock than anything. That's actually almost all of my designs, floating rocks. So, oh yeah, there's also collision damage. Let's try that real quick. I've actually tried this with my Zephyrian. I always tend to stay far behind the Vulcans, so let's collide. Save this. And wow, nothing as expected. Yeah, so that's that. So let's go to my biggest, meanest ship I have built. Well, not necessarily, actually. I have built a new ship recently that is quite nice. Yeah, let's destroy all these. So I'll show you my biggest ship I've ever created. This is Flarion. The Flarion. Biggest, meanest fighting boat I have. Well, it's actually the biggest, because it's the biggest ship I have. And it's excessive, because there's no real reason for it to be this big. It says right there, 10,000 blocks. The capacity this game has for the amount of other... The maximum amount of blocks this game has at the moment is 50,000. And this uses 1/5 of that. This ship alone is creating lag on my PC. That's not good. This ship, oh my god, this ship is... There's a lot of empty space inside of it. That's not really good. There's a lot of unused space. And it's just a waste. So I thought to myself, well, if I can make a ship this big with this kind of weaponry, I can make it smaller with the same kind of weaponry. And that's all it did. But I'll show what this ship can do before I go to my next ship. Because my next ship... I've changed some of these weapons to not be as powerful, but at the same time, it's more powerful. So, let's just watch this. So, this is the Flareon, as it stands in the water when no enemies are about. And this is the Flareon when there is an enemy. Turns on all of the shields and begins firing upon the enemy. These small turrets are built for anti-air, and it has high penetration of armor, both wood and metal. These turrets, I don't really remember, but I think they're also either armor piercing or high explosive. These smaller turrets are actually EMP turrets. EMP are useful for taking out electronics and things like that in the ship, like the AI, like that, and shields, but these turrets don't have enough EMP in them to take out shields.
Turning off. Turning off.
That's an easy enemy, by the way. So, yeah. Oh, and it also has some missiles with some flares stuck to them. So when an enemy ship or plane or something like that with missiles is firing, these flares will be fired. If I go to the planes, I think the Drake has missiles. So there it goes. Yep, the missiles are following the flares. So let's
taking
turn
control.
This into combat mode, and the anti-air on my ship is tearing the Drake apart. These small turrets are really good against wood, like it just shreds them. It's amazing. Lock button.
Turning off.
There's a lot of weird buttons in this game. Stacked engines. So yeah, this is the big Flareon. But I made an even better version of this ship. And that ship is called Vaporeon. Bop. This ship, well, I'll spawn in the Flareon right beside it. Cause, oh, the game is lagging. Hello, there we go. Just look at the size difference. Like, it's almost like a quarter of the size of it. This ship is 3,500 blocks. It's quite small, actually. It's a third of the size, just above that. A third of the size in blocks, sheer volume. This ship is 10,000, 3,500. That's quite the difference. And the funny part is, they have almost the same equivalent in firepower. But the Vaporeon, on the other hand, you saw how many shields this had. Like, every turret had a shield, right? Look at the Vaporeon when the shields deploy. I'm going to despawn that and remove it. That's gone. The Vaporeon when the enemy spawns in. Oh wait, oops. Ship the Marauder. Just look at it. It turns into a shield fucking fortress. And oh my god, this ship has firepower beyond firepower. It has missiles, flares, big MP cannon that breaks down shields, two high caliber, high explosive turrets, and four of the same kind of anti-air turrets. All equipped with shields, with strength 3, and my boat is ramming the other boat. What the hell are you doing?
Moving out.
Back off, you dumb piece of boat. No.
Moving out.
Jesus Christ. What is with you? I am...
Turning off.
No, no. I'm in control. I'm in control. Reverse. What the... Oh, the AG rounds. The bullets with the green traces after them are the high explosive ones. The light blue is EMP. Darker blue, I guess, is armor piercing. And those are the ridiculous missiles that just tears through ships. I've yet to put this in the campaign, but this ship, with its sheer destruction capabilities, is just amazing. Like, damn, this ship. I absolutely love this game. There's so much you can do in it. Like, I've made ships, because that's what I know, but I'm actually working on a sort of helicopter thing. I don't know how to do it, but I'll figure it out at some point. But I also tried to make a catamaran, like you can see it right here. And this is so funny when you try to use it. If I'll spawn this in, there we go. This is just fun. This is only fun. When you stand inside of this and you turn on the engines, it tries to fucking leave the atmosphere. Like, damn. And when you press reverse while it's doing a wheelie like that, it just dives into the water. It's amazing. It's fun. I'll make it into a locked camera. There we go. What the hell is this?
Turning off.
No, don't combat. That was only, like... Oh, wait, it's toppled over. Can we make it flip? No, we can't. Nope, it's upside down. Well, goodbye, sweet prince. Oh yeah, and the gravity. Gravity's my bitch. If you stand on the boat while it's up, turns upside down, gravity is still downwards from the boat's perspective, so you fall upwards. Funny. Open. No, not open beta. Early access games. I love them. They're so fun. So many small bugs and all that. I cannot wait for the game to get a multi-core support, because I think it's Unity or something that doesn't have that feature yet. When the new version of Unity comes out, this game will be amazing. Like, holy shit. So, oh my god, this game is just sheer power of imagination. I've actually, one last thing, the workshop, you can actually get things from the workshop that other people have made, and I have gotten this thing. Just want to look at it, and oh my god, it's fun. This thing, oh my god, I'll probably leave a link to it. But damn. It's a helicopter. No, an Osprey. Or whatever it's called. It's just fun. Sheer fun. I have not made this. I repeat, I have not made this.
Listening.
I'm going to destroy it. Dissolve! Dissolve! But this will be it for this time. Like, favorite, and subscribe for more videos. And remember, what you demand, I shall serve. Bye!